morning, everyone. It's great to be here. I'll just spend about 5 to 7 minutes talking about AWS and the culture of innovation here, and then I will hand it off to two of our fabulous customers who are going to talk to you about how they have been in their journey of machine learning and how they have been able to apply machine learning to solve their business problems. So this is what I would like to share to you today. You know, why do we have this conversation on AI/ML? How are our customers innovating with AI/ML? And how are we bringing the best of AWS services into India to help everyone here innovate? So I'll just very quickly build this slide. You can see the statistics for yourself. Why AI/ML? The real statistic that I like in this is it just takes about 88 seconds to train a large image classification system on the cloud, and that's how much it has evolved. If you go back in time about 2012-2013, this was taking probably a number of days to train image classification algorithm on the cloud. Now this has just come down to a mere 88 seconds thanks to all the innovation that's happening on the algorithms as well as on the chipsets. So what's our mission at AWS? Our mission is to ensure that we're able to put machine learning in the hands of every developer out there. And we have got a service called as SageMaker, which helps you do that. It's got hundreds of built-in algorithms. And we are trying to innovate pretty much on a daily basis, bringing in the best of features on SageMaker. And I was just talking to our customers that the most recent feature that we have launched in re:Invent is about it's called as SageMaker Debugger and SageMaker Monitor, and one of the cool features it has got is about model explainability. So we have adopted what's called as the SHAP analysis framework, SHAP, which helps you do model explainability on whatever models that you are developing, which is becoming a real hot topic in AI. How do you explain your model and ensure that your leadership team is convinced of the output your model is producing? So why AWS for AI/ML? We've got the broadest and deepest of the services out there. You can really accelerate your adoption of ML through SageMaker, and it's built on the most comprehensive cloud platform. I'll talk about some of these features. These were, So these were announced at AWS re:Invent. For those of you who had a chance to listen to Andy Jassy's keynote, out of the 3 hours, pretty much for 2.5 hours, he spoke about the innovations we have done on analytics and machine learning. So what excites me about is the SageMaker Studio IDE that you see out there. We have come out with SageMaker Autopilot, which is our version of AutoML. So across classification and regression, you will have 51 algorithms to choose from. And what we have done is we have ensured that there is a lot of transparency built in terms of helping you use Autopilot. So we have been able to generate multiple Jupyter notebooks when these 51 algorithms are run, so that you know, why are we suggesting, you know, Model X, let's say an XGBoost, as the best algorithm for the data set that you have created? And SageMaker Model Monitor and Debugger is what I spoke about in terms of model explainability. And there are some more new features that have come out, which is Amazon Search, Amazon Kendra. I'll talk about that a little bit. We have also come out with, you know, with 20 years of the retail experience, we have come out with a new service called as Amazon Fraud Detection, which probably everyone should try out, as well as Amazon Forecast. Okay, so the problem statement here is, you know, employees spend about 20% of their time looking for information, and 44% of their time they are not able to get the information that they are looking for. So what are the key challenges here? 80% of the enterprise data is unstructured. There are a lot of keyword engines, data in silos, and it's, you know, it's really, really complex and cumbersome to build an enterprise class search engine, ensuring that you're able to bring all the data together, and then you're able to build multiple ML models, which is going to fetch the data that you are looking for, right from your NLP engines to able to do text summarization and everything else. So that is a really, really complex problem to solve. So what we have done is we have come out with what is called as Amazon Kendra, which is, you know, we are really reimagining how enterprise search is being done today. It involves NLP queries, it involves, Comprehend, which is text summarization. So we have brought in all these features together under one service called as Amazon Kendra, through which you will be able to do an enterprise search. So I'll just briefly tell you what it looks like. So let's say, for example, you've got an internal search engine and this is what you want to try out. You want to know what time does the gym open. So if you look at today's, and this is a live example, and if you look at today's enterprise search engines, this is an output that you would probably see within your organization. So it doesn't give you the context. So with Amazon Kendra, the same question, this is the answer that you would probably get. And it also tells you from where the data is being fetched and the quality of the data, and also tells you there are about 152 search results. So this is what Amazon Kendra can do for you. We strongly encourage you to try out Amazon Kendra so that you are able to benefit from this service. What we have done across India, I'll very quickly again build this slide. Understanding that we are a country of multi-languages, we have ensured that every one of our service is being built for the most popular languages, and there is a very strong pipeline to support as many languages as possible. So what's the call for action? So we in Amazon very strongly believe in the culture of innovation. We don't believe that, we are always right and what we deliver is what customers ask for. We have got a culture of working backwards. We interact with customers, understand what they ask for, and then build our services towards what customers ask for. So there is a strong culture of experimentation and innovation. We would strongly encourage every one of you to try out all your experiments, not be afraid of failure, and then take it forward from there. So I'll stop here and hand over the session to Navaneethan, who will be our next speaker.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bala. Thank you.